Hello everyone and welcome to another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials. My name is Richard Evans and today I want to show you a brand new exciting product, which is this, the NewTek NDI PTZ UHD Camera. Ta-da! Now, this camera is awesome. It supports resolutions up to 4K 60p. It has a 30x optical zoom, and it has a state-of-the-art Sony sensor in there for gathering up all that data and converting it to a video source like HDMI or into NDI. And it's also PoE enabled, which means that you can plug this camera directly into a PoE switch or the Tricaster Mini 4K, and that's all you need to get video, audio, tally, control, and power, which is awesome. All right, so let's go ahead and show you how to set it up and get it working. All right, so step one, we're gonna need to connect this camera. So looking at the back of the system, we have a couple of different ports on the back. So you have the power connection, USB, an NDI port, an 1/8-inch jack for auxiliary audio input. You also have RS-232 ins and outs, and an RS-422 connection for conventional PTZ use. There's even an HDMI 2.0 output as well. All right, but in this example, I'm gonna show you the power of NDI by simply plugging in one cable into the back of this. Now, step two in connecting the PTZ UHD camera is I need to plug the other end of that Ethernet cable that I plugged into the camera into either a PoE switch, or in my case, since I'm using a Tricaster Mini 4K, plug it into one of these NDI ports on the back, and we're good to go. All right, now I have my camera and my TriCaster connected, so now let's move over to the TriCaster interface to pull the video feed from this camera into our switcher. So on input number one, I'm going to click on this gear icon to open up this pop-up so that I can click on this source drop-down and find my camera. So we'll go through here, and there it is, my PTZ UHD camera. Click on this. And automatically you'll see that I have an image showing up on input number one here. So I'm just here in the NewTek studio by myself, being socially distant and responsible. So what I want to do is go ahead and manipulate some of the PTZ shots, because right now it's just showing the back of our studio, which doesn't do us much good. So let me go ahead and go to the PTZ tab here. And first things first, you'll see I have 16 different presets to choose from. This is where you can go to take a snapshot of different camera positions and then click on them to move the camera without having to physically move the joystick around, kind of thing. So let's take a snapshot of this camera position first. Right, now let's go ahead and go to the bottom and check out our other controls. So I have my pan and tilt controls here, my zoom controls, focus and iris. I'm going to leave those just auto for now, so it'll just automatically control all of that for me. Now we can go into the camera's administrator panel to do a little bit more fine-tuning, let's say if we want to white balance our cameras, etc., and I'll show you that in a second. But first, let's go ahead and aim this camera at something a little prettier than the back door. So let's move it over here, and check it out. There we are. Now we have a nice 4K 60p footage of my quarantine haircut. Okay, so let's see. I'm gonna take a snapshot of this camera position, so let's pose for it. All right, so now I have this goofy photo of me, so where I can now just click on these different camera positions, and then the camera will rotate around. So let's go ahead and click on number one, and watch it spin over there. All right, and then we'll come back to number two. Awesome, pretty cool. Okay, so the next thing that I want to show you is how to do a little bit more adjusting to this camera. So I will click on the input tab, and for my sources, to the right of that, you'll see it says device webpage. I'm going to click on that, and that is going to open up the admin panel for this camera. So by default, the username for our cameras is admin, and password is admin as well. All right, and here's where you can go to make even more changes to this camera. So across the top, we have three tabs here, video source. This panel will basically allow you to do your pan, tilt, zoom, and preset controls from here. And then the next option in the middle is gonna be where you can go to fine tune some details of your camera. So for example, if I click on this drop down for video settings, this is where I can go to manage the different elements of my exposure, also the picture, so I can, you know, turn up my brightness, saturation, etc. I can white balance my camera from here and also do some more detailed focusing from here. Now you also have an option for under audio settings to manipulate your different audio settings as well here. All right, let's go to the top of the page in administration. And in this tab, this is where you can go to rename your camera, also update it, reboot the device, power it on, factory reset, yada, yada, yada. So this is kind of where you can go into the nitty-gritty details of your camera. All right, that's pretty awesome, but wait, there is more. So go ahead and let's see here on my camera. I'm gonna go and open up my switcher. So we also have a tally light built into this camera as well. So check this out. I'm gonna go ahead and bring up input number one on preview. And that light's gonna turn green. Awesome. All right, and now let's go ahead and bring it up on program, and that's gonna turn red. Ta-da! So now you know when this camera is active and ready to go. So as you can see, this is a really remarkable camera. It has your 4K 60p resolution. You have one cable with PoE so that you can get your video, audio, tally control, and power. And then you can control it from any NDI-enabled device that's on your network. Now for more information about this camera, talk to your local reseller or visit our webpage at newtek.com. And for more tutorials like this one, visit youtube.com/newtekinc. Until then, thank y'all so much for watching, and we'll see you next time on another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials. I don't know why I said it like that, but I did. Bye.